It is the pernicious purveyor of preposterous pomposity, manipulating the minuscule minds of the masses of miscreants. Once again, your host of the King's Court, the suntan Superman, the King of Connecticut, Matt Granahan. And I am here welcoming back a guest we've had on the show in season one. This man is an absolute legend, considered by many to be the greatest South Carolina Gamecock ever to grace the field, one of only four consensus All-Americans in the history of the Gamecocks football franchise. This man has had a storied career in professional wrestling, in World Wrestling Federation, World Championship Wrestling, in Japan, you name it. Also played in the NFL. He is a true legend and he is a true patriot, and he is the patriot, Del Wilkes. How you doing, Del?
Good, Matt, and I agree with everything you said.
Thank you. You're a wise man. It's good to see you again. So last time we did the court, as we always do, we call into Brian at the main studio for Radio Sports Network in Chicago, and we do it over the phone. That's not as fun. Face-to-face is a lot more fun, and we're in Gamecock season right now, and we're really at the home of Gamecocks football when it comes to the place where you want to watch the games, where you want to have a burger. Best burgers on the East Coast. I just had the trifecta, and also the pork sliders here are amazing. Of course, we're here at Burger Tavern 77 on Devine Street here in Columbia, South Carolina. And it must bring back a lot of memories for you to be right here by 5 points, Del.
It does. As I was coming through earlier, coming over here to meet you, coming through 5 points, while it's changed, it still brings back good memories. And being close to the stadium like this, this is my hometown, Columbia, South Carolina. So it's a very, very special place for me.
Now I want to ask you, just tell us a couple of your memories from the gridiron in the years that you played, because those were some amazing years that people still talk about in Gamecock history.
Well, my freshman year was 1980, and what better way to start off by being teammates with a Heisman Trophy winner? I was an offensive lineman, so as a freshman, I got to block for one of the greatest running backs that's ever played college football, George Rogers. We had a very good team that year, went to a Gator Bowl. Had a couple of mediocre years after that, but followed it up my senior year, 1984, with the first team ever win 10 games in Gamecock history. I was very fortunate. I was captain of that team, most valuable player of that team, and also a first team consensus All-American. So a couple of mediocre years in between, but in the beginning and the end, two special years.
Mm-hmm. Now, what do you think of the Gamecocks this year? What are you thinking for this season?
I think we're still a young team, there's no doubt about that. We've got talent on this team. It was pretty much bare cupboards when Coach Muschamp got the job. They've done a good job of recruiting. We're missing some offensive linemen for today's game. Of course, we're missing Debo, we're missing Bryson Allen Williams. So there's some talent there that we need that's not going to be on the field today against Texas A&M. But we're headed in the right direction, and I think we all are going to have some patience with this. We're going to have great moments, then we're going to have disappointing moments, as you do with young teams. Young teams are trying to find their identity, trying to gel, trying to become a cohesive unit, which we're doing all those things. I think we can have a good year, but it still may not show up in the one loss column to be what we wanted it to be. We can still be better, get better, improve, and maybe win six games. But just be patient. We're on the right path.
Absolutely. Be patient, fans. And speaking of professional wrestling, we talked about your career, such a storied career. One of our mutual friends, the Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez, who we just had on the show, legend, of course, from the ring, the NWA. I'm going to be on his upcoming show November 11th in Union, South Carolina. Tell us a story of the Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez. What fun story you can tell?
Well, I got a lot of them, and most of them I probably couldn't share with the audience, adult-oriented. But anyway, I've known Manny since 1986, which was the year I broke into the business. And I was very, very fortunate. When I was breaking into the business, I got to travel on the road with a guy named Wahoo McDaniel, who literally took me under his wing and treated me like a son.
Speaking of football, Wahoo McDaniel, a legend from the New
great football players. Oklahoma All-American there. Yeah. And through Wahoo, I met Mandy. And I got to sit back and watch a lot of matches with Wahoo and Mandy. Now, I didn't learn a lot of scientific wrestling from watching those two guys. Mm-hmm. They were basically chop fests, and they beat each other with bull ropes and bells. But I gained a lot of experience being around those guys, picking their brain and just learning stuff about the business.
Well, Manny Fernandez told a story on our show about Wahoo McDaniel that he chopped his chest so hard that Manny's nipple literally peeled right off of his body.
I wouldn't doubt it one bit.
So absolutely. Now, we're talking about professional wrestling. I showed you a match before we got started. UFC Hall of Famer Stephan Bonner, one of the top guys that I manage in the Real Shooters, my new tag team. What do you think of these guys crossing over from the world of mixed martial arts and UFC to the squared circle in professional wrestling?
I think it's great. I think it's great for them. I think it's great for the business of professional wrestling. I was watching the match. He told me the guy had only been in the business about 6 months. He looked great. He looked phenomenal. His stuff looked real. It looked legitimate. So I think it helps professional wrestling. It helps those guys continue a career. And they bring a lot. We got a lot to offer, man. A lot of talent.
And that might be, a lot of folks say that's missing today. The matches, it doesn't look like people are trying to win. They're not trying to get to that pin. They're not trying to get to that submission. You're doing a lot of crazy, outlandish moves. And who better to show them and give them a reality check than my tag team of Stephan Bonner and Phil Baroni?
Absolutely. You're in there for the ultimate victory, to get your hand raised. And you're right, a lot of it nowadays looks just like a choreographed dance. Yeah. It's just spot after spot after spot, move after move after move. When, again, it's all about the victory. It's about getting your hand raised. So at some point in time, you need to get on the guy covering and try to get a 1-2-3.
That's right. Well, Dell, I want to thank you for your time today. It has been an absolute pleasure. I want to thank the folks here at Burger Tavern. Strongly encourage anyone listening in South Carolina. This is where you need to watch the game. You'll run into legends like Dell Wilkes. This is where they all hang out. Burger Tavern 77, Columbia, South Carolina.
Go Cogs.